Tactically, you know, we had a bit of a struggle that game, and you never want to be the reason why you lose a game. So the more the defense went out there and made plays, we knew we had to step up, whether it was getting a first down, keeping the chains moving, giving them a rest, keeping them off the field. We had to do our part because defense was balling that game. Like, they was doing their thing. And, you know, we always had faith in our defense. We knew it was going to be games where, you know, maybe they didn't have their best game and we would pick them up. But we never felt like, all right, we got to score this many points because, you know, defense going to give it up. Like, we never felt that way. We honestly felt like defensively we were a better team than we were offensively. And offensively, we just never wanted to cost our team the game. We didn't want to turn the ball over. You know, we didn't want to make mistakes. And when the defense needed us to make a play, we wanted to be there to make it.
Screen passes. Yes, he's back. Yes, he's the pass complete to Beggs. Yes, he's passed. Gets his pass
I feel the way our offense played, it complemented our defense and vice versa. I mean, every week in practice, we competed to be dominant, you know, and I feel that Middle Tennessee game, we actually showed that. I mean, like I said, I don't remember play by play, but I do remember going in there. Obviously, it was hot. You know, everybody was, you know, going through the motions a little bit here and there because of the heat. I do remember that, but I remember going out there and coming together as a whole, as a defense, you know, and just pulling that win out. I feel we all worked together. We fed off the offense and we came up with the victory. Middle Tennessee was a tough team, man. I think offensively, I remember that was a tough battle. They had some skilled guys. The offensive line wasn't too big. Again, interior, but it wasn't too big, not bigger than some of the ones I've seen and faced for years. But nonetheless, they were athletic and strong. But, of course, you know me, I hold my own, so that ain't about nothing. But I do tip my hats off to them. Because again, man, they were really, 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 really talented, man. And if I'm not mistaken, that year or the year afterward, they were, you know, in postseason play. So.
Come on.
Gatsby's pass. Correction, Jason Swiger will attempt the kick.
The way we practiced, the way we challenged each other, there were times we were coming off the line trying to make sacks, and we had Chev would come up to me and be like, "I'm getting this next sack, Reed. I'm getting this next sack, Jay Reed." So it wasn't just one of us. It was all of us always competing against each other, just trying to step up and be the next playmaker. You know what I mean? But we all knew our responsibilities. We were all doing our job. But we knew we were always pushing each other, and it showed up in practice too. I couldn't tell you how many times we got into it with the offensive line, but we knew at the end of the day we were always trying to make each other better. Half the time, me and Tim would go at each other as if we hated each other during training camp, but we knew at the end of the day we were always trying to make each other better, and it showed.
Double pass to Eugene Grove. Swing pass is
we go to Purdue, you know, we all had the confidence that we could win that game. Fortunately, it didn't turn out the way we thought, but I know, you know, Tim mentioned it, a couple other guys mentioned it about our coaching staff. You know, they were second to none. You know, we had so much confidence going into that Purdue game to end up hanging there in the first half and then getting the wind taken out of us a little bit, but to be able to bounce back to go against Middle Tennessee, I believe we were up 14-7 at halftime, if I'm not mistaken. Then we go into the second half and we end up winning 17-7. So, you know, for the defense to, you know, hold a shutout there in the whole second half during that game was second to none. But I think everybody remembers us sitting on the tarmac the next day because remember we got stuck over there in Middle Tennessee. And how about Coach Flem walking on that plane? You guys got to remember that. You got to remember that one, man. That was the funniest thing. That's, I think, where he started that song. What was it? Joe, hey, Bo Diddity Bop. I wish I had.
Flem.
No, but that game turned the corner for us, man. You know, we just had confidence. You know, I know the offense, the special teams had so much confidence in the defense, thought they could just stop anybody, you know, second to none, you know. And then, you know, the offense on other hands would carry people, you know. It was like everybody's saying, man, it was such a team effort. And it was on both sides of the ball that just carried everybody, you know, and the coaching staff to keep everybody together, you know, in practice when you're fighting hard like that and stuff. It was second to none, man. It was a special environment. You know, it was really special.
Getsy's pass. Santil with Glenn Mark sacked. Banks on the carry. Yes, he's back. Sees swing pass complete. Thank you. for a loss back at the... Harris.